Hi there, welcome to Wristwatch Talk, and today we're going to be talking Smith Commando PRS-47. There are some similarities between the PRS-25 and the Commando, but we'll go over those, and let's just get straight into it. So you have the packaging here. Here's a nice watch roll provided by Time Factors. Time Factors on the front of it. You've got this nice suede material on the inside. Nice two-button closure. It's a little bit different to the previous pouch you may have seen. It was like a red pill kind of case. This one is a little bit more substantial. You get a cleaning cloth. Usually would be in this. They were using these yellow ones for a really long time. So a little bit of a difference. This is where the watch sits on in the watch roll. Nice, soft material here. You have the Time Factors warranty card and the kind of instruction manual. The previous models were always printed with PRS-25 Everest, and now each warranty card is printed with the correct kind of model. So Commando, Expedition. So that's a nice little touch. You've got the specs of the watch, so you can pause that and just read them if you would like. And you've got a general care guide. And on the last page, you have the serial number and the date that the watch was purchased. So the watch itself, here it is. This is the Smith Commando PRS-47. Before we get into it more, I will say there's a couple of other videos of the Smith Commando, but not of the tropical dial, but of the previous model with the black dial. I'll quickly show you a picture of that one. That is this one here. And the one difference I want to show you that you can see in the photo that I'll show you here now is the hour hand. And the hands in general have been dramatically kind of changed in size. They were a little bit disproportionate to the dial. As you can see, the hour hand on this black version was quite long and stretched over the, zoom in a bit, stretched over the hour markers, whereas now you can see it kind of stops just shy of the hour markers. There's like a couple of millimeters there, and I think that makes a big difference, and the watch looks much more proportionate. The hands look much more proportionate to the dial. The minute hand and both hour hand have also been thinned down quite a bit. You can see they look quite fat there, and again they were a little bit too big for the dial and looked like there was something off. So that's been changed. The other changes from that model, the signed crown is no longer the S, but it's now the crown logo. The back of the watch no longer has the ID guy's logo engraved, but it now just says Smith. And let me just unhook it. As you can see, it just says Smith. Previously, it did have the ID logos, engraving on the back. Some people said they didn't like that it had that on the back, but wouldn't have been an issue for me, but still. And the other difference is the clasp. That's one of the major differences, really, because people had an issue with the clasp on the previous model. Or some people had an issue. This is now this two-piece kind of deploying push button clasp, like on the Smith Everest that I previously showed you, instead of the friction clasp. So let's go over the dial briefly. It's using a tropical dial, so more of an aged vintage look to it. Something that some people really like, some people don't like, kind of the vintage kind of look to watches. They want it to look, you know, they want something modern looking. But if you're looking for something that's a little bit different to the Everest, whether it's because you don't like the Mercedes hands or whether you don't like the kind of homage feel that it gives to the Rolex Explorer, then this could be a model for you. It's got that really nice 36 millimeter case size. The case is exactly the same as the Everest. It's a great fit on the wrist, but obviously it's got its own unique look, and I think the tropical dial really adds to that look. I think it's really nicely done. You can see the hands have a slight bevel to them in the middle. I think that second hand that it reaches so far over the dial looks really nice. Sometimes you can assign it, you get it kind of glistening in the light and it catches the light nicely. I kind of like that there's no lume on there, and yeah, I like how it kind of spans over the dial. The lume on this is the same as what was on the Everest, so X1C3 is it? I think I said that right. Let me just double check. X1C3 Superluminova, yeah. But the indices themselves have a more aged look to them. On the Everest, they're kind of like, you just got kind of the look that you get from using X1C3 Superluminova, which has a kind of green tinge to it sometimes. But these don't really have that as much. They have more of a yellow kind of brown look to them. If you compare the pictures, you'll see what I mean. And you can even see a little bit on the hands here, because they have a slightly different look to them to the markers, the indices, and that's the kind of look that you get on the Everest. The brown on the dial is really nicely done. It sometimes in certain light looks really, really kind of like a velvety chocolate brown. And in other lights, depending on the AR coating and how it hits it, it looks a little bit duller. You can see when I angle it, it's kind of got a really nice look to it with that kind of blue AR coating as well. I think it really adds to it. One thing to notice, they do this in an acrylic version, so plexiglass. I obviously like acrylic crystal. I have Laurier watches with it, and they're some of my favorite pieces. For me, normally on polished watches, I would rather have a sapphire crystal as opposed to acrylic, because the watch gets scuffed up so much everywhere. Because of the polishing, I kind of want the crystal to stay at least clear. Whereas on a brushed case like the Laurier Falcon, one, it's got a white dial, so I don't see it anyway that much. But let's say the Laurier Neptune, the brushed case kind of stays brushed and I don't really see any major marks on there. It doesn't kind of get all scuffed up, and so I like that the acrylic kind of just is on that one. But whereas on this one, it's kind of, I don't want both the acrylic and the brushing to get really scuffed up, so I kind of like it that it's sapphire. But you have the option, which is nice. Show you the dial a bit more. So you're using the they're using the rivet bracelet that you've seen before. You've got these signed clasp, which is again very much the same as on the Everest. But yeah, you've got this other dial, and I really do think that the dial and the hands and everything looks really nice. I think it would look really nice on a few other straps, on a brown strap. You've got this lovely case size. Let me just put it on the wrist. Kind of won't go any more really into it. I just wanted to show it off really, show the watch, really how it looks. This is how it looks on wrist, on my wrist anyway. As best I can show you behind the camera. You can see that nice second hand. And yeah, that's it really. This is not an exact kind of homage to the Rolex Commando. The dial is slightly different. The triangle at the 12 o'clock is not there on a original Commando. The logo is kind of pushed up the Rolex crown, and some of them don't say Commando, some of them do. One other thing to note that I haven't really mentioned is the 3 and the 9 are kind of pushed out a little bit more than what you'd see on the Everest, so it gives the dial, I know, maybe more of an open feel to it. It looks a bit more open than on the Everest, that looks a bit more kind of the, I don't think they are, but the indices look a little bit bigger on the Everest, but I think that's just more of an illusion because the dial is kind of stretched out on here. So that's it anyway. Just a quick look at the watch. So if you're interested, I believe as of today, which is the 26th of November, on Sunday there's going to be a store opening where they'll be releasing more of the Commando dial in sapphire and in plexi. For plexi, I think it costs £310 and £325 for the sapphire, and they've also got a few other pieces up. One piece that you may have already seen is the lovely looking Smith Jubilee Aventurine dial, and that one is really nice looking. It's got a really nice Aventurine dial. Try and find a picture of it. Just bear with me. Here it is. I've got it up. And it comes with a Jubilee bracelet. Here it is. As you can see, that's the Aventurine dial. I think I'm saying that right. And it's going to be £365. Celebrate 25 years of selling watches on the internet. Limited edition of 500 pieces and will not be available once these have been sold. Yeah, so you can go to the website and check that out. Looks really nice. Also have a little video here, just to give you an idea of how it looks. But yeah, that's that. Anyway, thanks for watching. Good luck if you go for a purchase on Sunday. It's always a bit tight, but go in there, save your details, and create an account, and good luck to you. All right, have a nice weekend, and yeah, I'm out.